Lincoln, before his assassination, was certainly strongly criticized. He was Abraham Africanus, the friend of the blacks, but not a proper citizen. He was uncouth. He, all the matters that one could think of there. And he, when it came to voting, over and over again, Northerners tended to vote for more polished and better educated Democrats. This was just the way it was. And when Lincoln announced the Emancipation Proclamation in 1862, it created such a hostile reaction that the Republicans lost most of those congressional races. So that there was great hostility. There was also hostility among fellow Republicans, most of whom were better educated. They thought they were smarter than Lincoln. They certainly had more experience than Lincoln. And they thought, this is a rough fellow who's come out of the West who doesn't really know what he's talking about. It took quite a while for a man like Charles Sumner, who, polished as he was, Harvard-educated, friend of Joseph Story in the Supreme Court, widely traveled in Europe, with always a pocket full of letters from the Duke of Carlisle and so on, to think anything good could come of Abraham Lincoln. But Lincoln managed him. Lincoln flattered him. Mrs. Lincoln also flattered Charles Sumner, who was easy to flatter, and he was indeed a tall, handsome, gallant, well-trained young man. And he became increasingly a part of the Lincoln entourage. When the Lincolns went out for a carriage ride, they would often take Sumner along with them. So that by the end, as Mary Lincoln wrote, he and Sumner and Lincoln were on the best of terms, and Mary said they played together like two young boys, which is unlikely, one thinks, for Lincoln, even more unlikely for a sedate Charles Sumner. But he relaxed with Lincoln. Now, this kind of transformation occurred with a great many people. So I think it's a mistake to think of Lincoln in his pre-assassination period as being disliked. He was suspected. He had many critics. But on the other hand, he also had many friends. Then comes assassination. This is the first great American assassination. There'd been an attempt on Andrew Jackson, but not successful. There'd been a couple of presidents who had died in office, but that's very different. The tragedy of it all, a man struck down in his prime, struck down of all things on Good Friday, brought to Americans a sense of total loss, especially since nobody knew where do we go from here. Nobody knew much about Andrew Johnson, except that he had a bad temper. There was no other alternative. And they thought, we're lost now with Lincoln. We have to follow in his steps and try to find out what they are. So increasingly, people wrote eulogistic biographies of Lincoln, nearly always finding him one of the great men, sometimes calling him a saint, which he wasn't. But they loved it. And that, I think, is the change that came about in Lincoln